291. What is the significance of this number? 291 is the number where number of children were actually abandoned in the year 2018 in Karnataka state only. Now you would be surprised that ये तो सिर्फ official number है, unofficial कितने number है? Now पहले के 3 महीने में इसी साल 2019 में already as per official estimates 71 kids have been abandoned. Now as per some estimates, you know, there is one child that is abandoned on a daily basis in the district of Kolar in Karnataka. अब हम क्या कर रहे हैं इन सब चीजों के लिए? कुछ नहीं. सुबह ऑफिस आकर शाम को ऑफिस से चले जाते हैं और वीकेंड पे अपना वर्क लाइफ बैलेंस मेंटेन करने के लिए कहीं घूमने चले जाते हैं या किसी मॉल में जाके पिक्चर देख लेते हैं. बट काफ़ी सारे लोगों ने अपना सारा जीवन, यू नो, अपनी सारी जॉब छोड़कर इन सब चीज़ों पर बिताना के लिए सोचा है. ऐसी एक ट्रस्ट है विश्रांति ट्रस्ट, जो कि इन सारे बच्चों के लिए, यू नो, इन सारे बच्चों के जीवन के लिए, उनके एजुकेशन के लिए सपोर्ट करती हैं. नॉट ओनली उनको सपोर्ट करती है बट आसपास के गांवों में जितने भी सारे विलेजेस हैं, दे सपोर्ट एम्प्लॉयमेंट ऑल्सो. जो लोग कुछ नहीं कर सकते उनको सिलाई बुनाई का काम करवा के कुछ ना कुछ उनसे बिजनेस करवाते रहते हैं, उनके प्रोडक्ट से प्रोडक्ट बनवाते हैं जो कि आगे बेचते हैं, कैटरिंग की सर्विस प्रोवाइड करवाते हैं, जाके कॉरपोरेट लेवल पर जाके कैटरिंग सर्विस देते हैं जो अच्छा खाना आप लोगों को प्रोवाइड कर सकें. बट एट द एंड ऑफ द डे द क्वेश्चन दैट नीड्स टू बी आस्क्ड इज व्हाट वी आर डूइंग. मैं आपसे ज़्यादा नहीं कहता बट अपने वीकेंड पे, यू नो, एक दिन किसी भी कुछ घंटे इन जाके बच्चों के साथ बिताइए, अपने बच्चे का बर्थडे में भी इन बच्चों के साथ एक बार सेलिब्रेट करिए. और इनके यहाँ पर ओल्ड एज होम भी है जो कि बुज़ुर्गों को, जो उनके बच्चे बाहर पढ़ते हैं या जिनके बच्चों ने उनको छोड़ दिया है, वो लोग आके रहते हैं. उनको आपसे कुछ नहीं चाहते, बस आपके जीवन का एक वीकेंड का एक घंटा मांगते हैं. अगर हर एक कोई बंदा अपने आसपास के एरिया में वीकेंड में सैटरडे या संडे सिर्फ एक घंटा देकर आ जाए, अपनी बातें शेयर कर ले, उनसे एक्सपीरियंस सीख ले, तो उन लोगों के पास भी सिखाने के लिए बहुत कुछ है. ऐसे ही हमारे इनके फाउंडर मिसेस सरसा से बात हुई, जो कि विश्रांति ट्रस्ट की फाउंडर है, जिन्होंने सारा ये स्टार्ट किया. कैसे उन्होंने अपनी एयरलाइन की जॉब, अच्छी खासी सैलरी वाली जॉब छोड़ के, यू नो, ये सारे लोगों को हेल्प करने का सोचा, क्या उनको स्ट्रगल्स है, क्या डे टू डे चैलेंजेस हैं, ये सारा लेट्स लिसन डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम हर ओन माउथ.
So ma'am, can you share me your story? How did you started and what led you to start this thing?
Yes, like I was saying, I studied in St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science, Bangalore. And as part of NSS, we were taken to this old age home. And for me, it was a shock that elders, I was 19 at the time, and elders could be left outside their homes. And you know, when I saw those elders, I found that not really happy. So I was very curious, and I was I always had a fondness for elders. And I kept going back there to talk to them, to spend time with them. I used to rub liniment on them. So in that experience has made me a good masseur. So anyone who has aches and pains, I'm still good at it too.
Do you know the exact year when you started out, or from how many years you were actually starting this?
2003 we set up the trust.
Okay.
And by that time, I had roped in my mother and my mother-in-law,
okay,
which I think was a very strategic move.
Okay.
it just so happened that both of them were like-minded and they loved the idea.
Uh-huh.
So three of us set up the trust.
Okay.
And soon we had 7 other trustees join us, so it became a public trust.
Okay.
In about 2004, and then we started, making plans as to how we want to do this.
Mm-hmm.
And we decided that we will start the elders home. We had the plans ready by 2007.
Now, how many people are staying in currently, or how many people do you support right now?
Right, we can support 24 elders.
Okay.
And our estimate, and we want to have only 30 children.
Okay.
The government, of course, came and told us when they did the inspection to get the registration done. Mm-hmm. They said you can have 100 children.
Okay.
But we definitely don't want to.
During all these years, you know, of running it, did you feel at any point of time, yaar, you know, ho gaya bas, I can't continue anymore, or did you require, did you needed any support or help from anyone or push from sir, then you keep on going?
See, the greatest Chanakyan in the world is God.
Okay.
He's a great strategist, because he never allowed me to feel that. When I thought my energy was going down, in would come another child with all that divinity in front of her and say, oh, you have to look after me. And there you have it, you can't, you know, a baby and God are the same. So how can you leave that child just like that? It's truly amazing. Now, or an elder would come and she would give me a hug and say, you're like my daughter. Someone to teach spoken English for children, and suddenly Jyoti Thyagarajan calls me and says, Rose and Peter, we're close, staying so close by, and why are you looking all over the world? And then I actually went the same day to look for them in Hoskote, and I met up with the most fabulous couple that I have ever met. Peter is a musician, he plays jazz and blues, he has his own band. Rose has been coming to is the favorite of our children.
So ma'am, can you tell us that how do you help in the job creation in the nearby areas and people who actually really deserve it?
Actually, there are around 12 villages around Vishranthi, between half kilometer to 12 kilometer radius.
Okay.
And having gone through the villages for our various, because we want to do vocational training, so we had gone through the villages, I found that not only do the youth need some vocational training, the women could do with help also, because most of the men are drunk most of the time and they do not contribute to the family at all. So that leaves the women with, having to scrounge for the basic necessities of life, food for the children, food for themselves. Many times they actually start this tobacco habit in order to kill hunger, which is actually disastrous, you know. They start tobacco in order to kill hunger, and tobacco of course gives rise to cancer, as most people know, and they suffer, you know. If we could somehow break the cycle and empower them, I thought, we should, we should be able to help. So we started the tailoring vocational training. So we started doing tailoring classes for them, and the best student we gave a tailoring machine so that they could start their own tailoring shop in that village, so 4 or 5 women could be employed in that place.
So guys, I'm really saddened, and main apni side se puri koshish karunga ki apna weekend at least kuch time main in jaise organizations mein jaake, you know, de sakun. Agar aapke paas koi story hai ya aap kuch chahte hain ki main kisi ko cover karun jisse ki usko yaar life mein kuch help out mile, so please share your stories with me, or I will be more than happy, you know, to cover those stories out. Thanks guys, cheers, and thanks for watching. Bye.